Hi guys, I'm Suprabha. Before we move on to the next topic, probability, I'd like to tell that many people suggested this topic. I'll just call out few random names. Those are Bhagwati, Hina, Piyush and Ravishankar. So let us start with the most awaited topic, that is probability. Now what does probability mean, or the definition of probability? It says how likely something is to happen. This simply means that when we are not sure about the outcome of any particular event, we talk about probabilities. So for example, whether it will rain tomorrow or not, we are not sure whether it will rain or it will not rain. So we can go for probability of that event. So we can say it reflects chance or likelihood of a particular event, and it is basically denoted as P of A, that means probability of event A, or P of B, and so on. This is all about the basic of probability. Let us see two examples based on the definition. First, tossing a coin. You know, whenever a coin is tossed, we either get head or 10. That means these are two possible outcomes. So probability of getting head or probability of getting tail will be, probability of head will be 1 by 2 or probability of tail will be 1 by 2. Next example is throwing a dice. We know dice has 6 surfaces or 6 faces. So the possible outcomes are either we get number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 6. The probability of getting any one number will be 1 by 6. So probability of 2 will be 1 by 6, probability of 6 will be 1 by 6 and so on. So with these two examples, we can conclude the formula for probability. It is number of desirable outcomes divided by the total number of outcomes. Let us correlate this formula with both the examples. Number of desirable outcomes. In tossing the coin, the number of desirable outcomes were 2. Either head can appear or either tail can appear. Suppose head is to be appeared, the number of desirable outcome will be 1 and total number of outcomes were 1 plus 1, that is 2. And similarly applies for throwing a dice. Next example, there are 8 pens in a bag. 5 are red, 3 are blue. We have a bag. There are total 8 pens. 5 are red and 3 are blue. What is the probability that blue gets picked up? Let us see what the formula says. Number of desirable outcomes. Now, what are the number of desirable outcomes? We want blue pen to be picked up, and there are total 3 blue pens. So, possible outcomes are, desirable or possible outcomes are 3. And what are the total number of outcomes? Those are 5 plus 3, that is 8. So this is the probability. Probability of blue getting picked up is 3 by 8. Let us see few important points. Probability is always between 0 and 1. Now why specifically 0 and 1? Because let us take the help of the formula. Number of desirable outcomes. Now the number of desirable outcomes will never be greater than the total number of outcomes. Why? Because here, as you can see, there are total 6 desirable outcomes, right? Now, and also the total number of outcomes are 6. Desirable outcomes 6 cannot be greater than the total number of outcomes. So this gives us 1. So we can say probability is always between 0 and 1. So this is a certain event, and probability of impossible event is equal to 0. This means that if there is an event that says we want a number, whenever a dice is rolled, we want number 7 to be appeared. But as we know, the numbers on dice are between 1 to 6. 7 cannot appear. So that is an impossible event, and probability of impossible event is always equal to 0. Here we can also write probability of certain event is equal to 1. Next, if probability of A or event A is greater than probability of event B, event A is more likely to occur than event B. I'll explain this with the help of one example. Suppose two coins are tossed. What will be the possible outcomes? Either both head will appear, or head or tail will appear, or tail or head, or both tails will appear. Okay. Now suppose event A is only both head appears. That means event A is where either one head appears, so the probability will be 1 by 2. And event B is both head appears. Both head appears will be, there is only one desirable outcome, so that will be 1 by 4. Now here you can see probability of A will be 0.5 and probability of B will be 0.25. So we can clearly say that event A is more likely to occur than event B. Similarly, if both the probabilities are equal, then both the events are equally likely to occur. Let us go through few terms that will always go through in probability. First is experiment. It says process that generates set of data. We'll correlate this term with the two examples that we saw. Experiment in this case is tossing a coin or throwing a dice. That is, these experiments are generating a set of data. Next, sample space. All possible outcomes of experiment. Tossing a coin was an experiment and it has generated a sample space that consists of head and tail. Similarly, in dice, we have 6 possible outcomes, that is 6 elements in sample space. Sample point. Each outcome in sample space. Sample space is also denoted as capital S. Each outcome means this is one sample point, this is second sample point. Similarly, in this sample space, we have total 6 sample points. It is also called as event or number of sample space. Moving on to last term, event. Sample point is also called as element or member of sample space. Events, those are single result of experiment, or more precisely we can say subset of sample space or subset of S. Now suppose we have an event, suppose a dice is thrown and we have an event that gives even number, so probability of A is equal to, even numbers are 2, 4, 6. Those are the possible outcomes, so or desirable outcomes. So the result will be 3 by 8. This is nothing but the event that gives the subset of sample space. This event can consist of single sample point or multiple sample points. Single in the sense, as the probability of getting head was 1 by 2. Here we are getting only a single sample point. Here we are getting multiple sample points. So this is all about the basics of probability. We'll see few more examples in the next video. Thank you. Thank you for your support till now. We'll need it further too. So please like the video, share with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thank you.